Good morning, Dreamhouse Nation. It's James Lewis of this Dreamhouse, the show that is all about the house. Before we get to our guest, Krysten Anderson, we're going to give out our email address. It's dreamhousenation@gmail.com. That's dreamhousenation@gmail.com. And the reason why we do that is we're going to give away tickets to Monster Jam. So if you're wanting to go to Monster Jam, write into dreamhousenation@gmail.com to win tickets. Our guest today is Krysten Anderson from Monster Jam. We will be discussing the upcoming Monster Jam events, and they're taking place on Saturday and Sunday, not just Sunday. Krysten, thank you for joining us.
Thank y'all for having me.
When is Monster Jam coming to Columbus, Ohio?
Well, Columbus, I think that we're going to be there here in a few short weeks. Actually, I'm pretty excited. I've been to Columbus, I believe, one other time, and I loved it, loved the arena. The city was great. The fans were even better, so I'm super excited to bring my Gravedigger truck back.
That is awesome. We're so excited to have you back on July 31st with two shows and August 1st with one show. So, I mean, it's going to be a great event as always. And then, of course, that first night, the first morning, your favorite part about it, at least my favorite part about any Monster Jam show, the pit party. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we are. We got a pit party for y'all, and of course, it's great to be back. Monster Jam, we've been gone for a really long time, so we're super excited to see our fans. The pit party is just a special meet and greet that we do for the fans right before the show. You can purchase your tickets to it at monsterjam.com, but it's an opportunity for you guys to actually bring yourself, bring your family, bring the kids and everybody down on the dirt where the trucks will be competing at later that evening, and you can get up close and personal with the trucks, get pictures in front of them, and myself and the rest of the competitors there will also be there to answer any questions that you guys have, take pictures with you guys. We're doing things a little differently from the past. We are a little social distance this year, and we can't be as close and up close and personal, and I won't be able to sign any personal autographs this year, but you guys can also, you know, you can show up, ask any questions, any pictures, videos, stay as long as you like, and I'll have pre-signed autograph cards there for everybody in the family to have one. So it's a little different, but we're slowly making steps to get back to some more normalcy here at Monster Jam, and pretty soon we're hoping we'll be wide open doing the handshakes, the hugs, the photos, up-close photos, autographs, just like we used to.
That is so cool, because that is the greatest thing about Monster Jam, in my opinion. I mean, obviously, it's a very intense sport. It's a very exciting sport. The great vehicles, the great drivers. But the best part about it is the fan interaction. And it seems that you all truly do care about your fans, where some sports, like I'm not going to name any, baseball, that decided, I don't want to show up to the All-Star game. Like, what? You're nominated for the All-Stars. We want to have you celebrate. Oh, no, that's okay. I'm going to pass. You would have never see that in Monster Jam, where Monster Jam drivers would turn down and go, no, that's okay. I could go to this event for the fans, but I'm not going to. Because Monster Jam drivers love their fans.
Yes, we do. We love our fans so much. And we know that our fans are the backbone and the foundation of Monster Jam to begin with. And if it wasn't for people coming out and spending their hard-earned money to come out here and watch me make my hard-earned money, then, you know, Monster Jam wouldn't even exist. We would be nothing without our fans, and especially my family personally knows definitely a lot of history with our fans. My dad being the creator of Gravedigger, we have a 40-year Gravedigger legacy, and if there wasn't so many Gravedigger fans all over the United States and now outreaching internationally and all over the world, then Gravedigger wouldn't be as iconic and as big and as loved as it is. And we thank you guys so much, because if it wasn't for you guys, just like I said, we wouldn't have been able to be bad to the bone for the past 40 years.
That is awesome. And then, of course, the nice thing about that pit party, it doesn't cost a lot of money. It's only $15 to have that type of interaction that you get nowhere else at no other sport. I mean, that is just so cool.
Yeah, absolutely. We love to keep things family friendly. We know that we have lots of families, lots of kids, but just fans of all different ages on all across the spectrum that want to come and see us. They want to see these massive trucks up close, because monster trucks are very unique. You're not going to see another motorsports vehicle like it. I mean, it's 12,000 pounds. It's got 1,500 horsepower. The tires itself are 5'6", and, you know, they can weigh up to 900 pounds. So they're just beasts, and people, they want to see them up close, and they want to see the people that pilot them too. So we want to give them that opportunity. We want to keep our prices family friendly. We've always tried to do that, and we encourage everybody to come out and get up close and personal with a monster truck.
Speaking about the people that pilot them, which vehicles do we get to see? Obviously, we're going to see Gravedigger because you're going to be there, but who else do we got?
I believe that we'll have a Mohawk Warrior there, that he's been traveling in my trailer. The Mohawk, Great Clips Mohawk Warrior is awesome. So it's got a big, giant Mohawk on the top of it. So people that are going to have Mohawks, or you guys love a good Mohawk, come on out, support Elvis Lionos. He'll be driving a Mohawk Warrior. Style your hair up in a Mohawk. Come get it painted purple. Paint it purple if you want. Come on out. He'll love it. And we have another lineup of some independent drivers that will be there. I'm not quite sure who they are just yet, but we've got some really great action coming to you guys. I promise you, you will not be disappointed. We've been, you know, driving our tails off all year long. We've been great. The competitions have been tight. I've been doing pretty good, so I'm excited to bring some skills back to Columbus.
That is so cool. So I understand that we have a Brutus going to be there. We have a Devastator going to be there. Obviously, the Mohawk, Rage, and then Raisin Cane, which I was disappointed that it's not the chicken restaurant.
Raisin Cane's, I know. But Raisin Cane, that's a great truck, a great build. Brutus, all those Kohler trucks, those are all great builds. They're really tough trucks, and I know that they're ready to come out there and show out and really compete against, you know, me and Elvis for sure. All of us are ready to throw down on the dirt that weekend. And like I said, I'm super excited to get back to Columbus. I thought that it was a beautiful city. And like I said, the fans were great. So I'm very excited to come back and see y'all.
Oh, gosh, yeah. We're excited to have you at Nationwide Arena. It's going to be so much fun. And then the great thing about our show, it airs in Columbus and Cincinnati. And down the road in September, early September, you're going to be coming to Cincinnati. But we'll have, hopefully, you back on the air to talk that up closer to the event. And the important question, now, of course, with Elvis going to be there, my mom is going to ask me this question probably three times. Even if I tell her no every time, she's still going to ask again. Does Elvis dance and sing?
Does Elvis dance and sing? I don't know. Maybe if you guys encourage him while he's out there doing his interviews on the mic, he might go out there and sing something for you guys. I don't know. He might be a pretty good dancer, but hey, he's a great guy, great competitor, and he's got a very iconic name. That's for sure. He never hears the end of it.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I can imagine. So what competitions are going to be at the event? And which ones have you been doing well at and thriving?
Well, I've actually been really doing good at all of them. We have four competitions come to you guys that weekend. We're going to kick things off with Monster Jam Racing like we always do. It's going to be head-to-head style racing, bracket elimination. So it's going to be two trucks racing against each other. And I've won quite a few races this year, so I'm feeling pretty good. I've got a pretty good success rate in racing. Then we're going to bring you guys the skills competition. You guys are familiar with that. We've brought it there the past couple years, where we'll be balancing those trucks on the nose. I mean, these trucks are 12,000 pounds, so that's a pretty impressive feat on itself. We'll be doing some wheelies, some sky wheelies, got some really awesome tricks for you guys. We'll still be doing the judgeszone.com, where you guys can get on your smartphones, and you go to judgeszone.com, and we'll give you guys a city code. You put in your city code that weekend, and you guys will actually judge us on those judged events. So whatever the fans want, whatever you guys are liking, whichever truck had the best tricks, you guys vote for them, and then we'll crown a winner. And then we're going to bring freestyle motocross to you guys after that. We've got some of the best in the nation doing freestyle motocross. They're going to be out there on their dirt bikes doing some awesome tricks for you guys. That will also be a judged event. And then we're going to bring the monsters back. We're going to do the donut competition. I've been dominating the donut competition. I love that competition. Nice. That's another judged event. And then we are going to round things out for the night with freestyle. And that's everybody's favorite. That's my personal favorite. And that's where the trucks are going to go out for 75 seconds and throw down, do some awesome tricks, some big jumps, maybe some crazy saves, maybe a little crazy crash. We don't know, but that's also going to be a judged event. And then at the end of it, we're going to average out our scores and we're going to crown a champion.
That is so cool. And of course, those points go towards your trip to Las Vegas at the end of the year, right?
Yeah, pretty much. We're collecting these points throughout the entire year, and we'll crown a series champion. So every point matters. Every vote counts. So we encourage people to come out, and it's a real competition. You know, we're coming out, and we are actually competing for trophies and points in front of you guys. I know it's very entertaining to watch, but it's not just entertainment. It's serious. So you guys come on out, bring your cell phones, vote for us, and hopefully we'll be able to crown a champion. And I've been doing pretty good. I'm leading in the points right now on that little series, so I hope that I'll be able to take it home.
That is awesome. So in other words, it's not the Harlem Globetrotters. This is legit. You guys are really fighting for the points and really fighting to win, and you need the fan support to win.
Yes, we do. We need our fan support definitely to win. We all are trying to make it to the World Finals, and that is the most prestigious event in Monster Jam, to be invited to the World Finals, to drive your butt off all year long and gain those points and get an invitation into the World Finals to battle it out with the best and the best of Monster Jam. I'm talking 20-year veterans, 30-year veterans, 10-year veterans, people that have been driving so much, you know, longer than Elvis and I, and getting to go head-to-head with them and possibly be crowned a world champion. So I'm very excited. My dad, he retired, a 4-time world champion. My brother Adam is a 5-time world champion. And my other brother Ryan is a 3-time world champion. So I'm hoping that I get to bring home another world championship trophy to the Anderson household and maybe rub it in my brother's face a little bit.
That is so cool. I was going to say, that is awesome that you got such a family tradition going on there. And it seems like you are really stepping out of those shadows and really doing it on your own there with being, you know, running the first place right now, and then shooting in the last couple of years when we've had you on, you've always been doing quite well with it. So, I mean, it sounds like things are really progressing in your career.
Absolutely. It's I've been competing with Monster Jam for about 5 years now. So it's been a few years since I've been to Columbus, but I mean, my skills and the amount of experience and stuff that I've gained just being on the road and being in these trucks, we learn something new every single day, and we're constantly progressing. And that's the great thing about Monster Jam is, you know, we're in our trucks so long and so many weekends that we have so much seat time, and we just get better and better every weekend. So I'm excited to show everybody what I've learned in the past few years.
Excellent. So before we let you go, Krysten, where on social media, where on the web, where can our listeners find out more about Monster Jam?
Well, you guys, Monster Jam has a big following on Instagram, so you guys can just look them up. They're just at Monster Jam, and they have a Facebook page. You can also follow them on Twitter, too. But if you want more information about the trucks, the drivers, the show times, where you can get tickets, everything like that, go to monsterjam.com. And it's a pretty simple, easy website to navigate. You can just click your location, and it'll show you every point in the year that we'll be visiting to an area near you, the show times, the prices. You can buy tickets right there. So, yep, look us up on Instagram, Facebook. Look me up on Instagram. I'm Krysten.Anderson, and I spell mine with a KrystenAnderson. So look me up on Instagram, and I'll be giving updates throughout the whole weekend on the show, too, if you guys aren't able to make it out.
Sounds great.